Hello friends, today we are going to calculate the vertical deflection at location D of given 2D portal frame, as well as we have given the flexural rigidity as a 4.92 into 10 raised to 13 in terms of Newton into mm square, and we have to use the Castigliano's theorem. So first of all, we have to assume a arbitrary load at location D, and at location D there is a 50 kN load in downward direction. So let us assume arbitrary load P as a 50 kN in the same direction as given D. So for the calculation purpose, we are going to assume arbitrary load, but which is 50 kN load in actual. So first of all, if we take the CD span and taking the D as a origin and sectional distance as a x meter, then for CD span, our moment is P into x in anticlockwise direction, and according to the moment sign convention, sectional left hand side clockwise and right hand side anticlockwise is treated as positive. But here our moment is in anticlockwise direction, so it is minus Px. Similarly, for B to C segment, if we take the C as a origin, then our sectional distance from the location C as a x. Now if we take the moment over section x, then it is P into 2 in anticlockwise direction. So for B to C segment, it is minus 2P. For AB segment, there are two possibilities. First one is section having the distance less than 2 meter, and second possibility is section having the distance greater than 2 meter. So let us take both the cases. So for first case, in which x is less than 2 meter, in this case our origin value is B, distance from origin B is x meter. Hence, if we take the moment at location x, then the value is P into, now perpendicular distance of load P from the section is total 2, and distance is x, so it is 2 minus x, and sectional left hand side anticlockwise moment is negative. So moment in segment AB, which is equal to minus P into 2 minus x. Now if for second case x is greater than 2, it means that our section value from distance B is x meter, and if we take the moment over here, then the load into perpendicular distance, which is equal to x minus 2. So our moment is P into x minus 2. According to the sign convention, the value is negative as the moment is clockwise in the right hand direction. So our moment at AB segment is minus P into x minus 2. Now both the cases having the different moment, but if we take del mx by del P, then the value is minus 2 minus x. For second case, it is minus x minus 2. Now multiplying these both values, we will have P into 2 minus x all square, while for second step it is P into x minus 2 all square. Now see, A minus B whole square or B minus A whole square, the value is A square minus 2AB plus B square. So for both the cases, our value is constant. We can take either case 1 or case 2 as the multiplication of moment with respect to del mx by del p is constant for both the cases. So let us going for the tabular form. As now for CD span, our value is minus px as a moment. Now distance of CD is given as 2 meter, and moment of inertia is not given, and it is taken I for all the segments. For B to C segment, our moment is minus 2p, distance is given as 1 meter, and origin is taken as a C. While for AB segment, we have calculated both the cases, and in both the cases the multiplication is constants. Hence we are focusing on first case, and moment is minus p into 2 minus x. So for the tabular form we have taken the three segments CD, PC and AB. Now going ahead for the calculation of deflection at location D as delta, according to the Castigliano's theorem, is 1 by EI into 0 to L moment at segment del MX by arbitrary load del P into DX. And we have given flexural rigidity EI, which is equal to 4.92 into 10 raised to 13 Newton into mm square. Now, according to the tabular form, we have to calculate partial derivation, which is del mx by del p. So, partial derivation of moment with respect to p, here it is minus x, or minus 2p, it is minus 2, and minus p into 2 minus x, it is minus 2 minus x. Now, using this equation, we have delta d, which is equal to delta cd plus delta bc plus del ab. Now using this equation for all the terms, we will have 1 by ei as a constant for all terms. First of all, for cd span it is minus px into x as a px square, so our value is px square dx and limit is 0 to 2. For second part, as b2c span, our value is minus 2 into minus 2p as a 4p dx and limit is 0 to 1 plus. For AB span it is 0 to 3 plus p into 2 minus x into minus 2 minus x. So it is p into 2 minus x all square dx. Now we know that our p value is 50 kilonewton. So we are replacing the value of p for this term as a 50 kilonewton. Now going ahead for the calculation step, here a minus b whole square as a square minus 2ab plus b square. For px square dx, now p value is 50 kilonewton, so it is 50 x square dx as a x cube by 3, and limit for this span is 0 to 2. For second step it is 4, p value is 50 and dx, integration of dx as a x, so limit is given as 0 to 1. And for the rest part it is p as a 50 into 4 dx as a 4x minus 4x dx, integration is 4x square by 2, and plus x square dx as a x cube by 3, and limit is 0 to 3. Now closing the limit, we will have now solving this term, we have delta D, which is equal to 483.33 by EI in terms of kilonewton meter cube. But we have given the maximal rigidity, which is 4.92 into 10 raised to 13 Newton into mm square. So let us put this value in terms of del D. As using Castigliano's theorem, we have calculated delta D as a 483.33 by EI in terms of kilonewton meter cube. But we have given flexural rigidity EI as a 4.92 into 10 raised to 3 in terms of Newton into mm square. So we have to convert this value in terms of kilonewton meter square. So 4.92 into 10 raised to 13 is as it is. For 1 Newton, it is 10 raised to minus 3 kilonewton. And for 1 mm, 10 raised to minus 3 meter, but it is square. So 10 raised to minus 3 square in terms of meter square. So all over it is 4.92 into 10 raised to 13 as a given value, and for 1 newton mm square it is 10 raised to minus 3, 10 raised to minus 3 square. So total value is 10 raised to minus 9 kilonewton meter square. So if we have to convert newton into mm square into kilonewton meter square, then keep noted that 1 newton mm square, which is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 kilonewton meter square. So our value in terms of kilonewton meter square as 49200. Now putting this value in equation, del D as a 483.33 divided by 49200, which is equal to 9.83 into 10 raised to minus 3 in terms of meter. So let us convert this meter into mm. We have to multiply this value by 10 raised to 3. So 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to 3 is 0, hence our value is 9.83 mm. So the deflection at location D due to 50 kilonewton load is 9.83 mm, and we have assumed P kilonewton or arbitrary load in downward direction, hence this deflection is in downward direction. So thus we can calculate the deflection at different location using the energy principle or Castigliano's theorem. Thank you.